this topic is extrinsic semiconductors. So in this there are two types of extrinsic semiconductor material. One is n type and the second one is p type. We will discuss later on the p type, and this is n type. How the n type will be formed, right? So there are already, we have discussed that, we know that silicon material having all silicon atoms which are neighboring each other and sharing covalent bond by sharing electrons to the neighborhood atoms. So if pentavalent atoms, that means pentavalent atoms are whose valence electrons 5, that means examples are phosphorus, arsenic and antimony. Phosphorus, arsenic and antimony, these are the pentavalent atoms. If the pentavalent atom is, one pentavalent atom is added to the intrinsic semiconductor of the material, let us assume that if one atom is added, this is pentavalent atom here, these are all silicons, but here the one pentavalent atom is replaced by one of the silicon atom, and since the pentavalent atom is having 5 valence electrons, so out of 4 electrons are shared like this. That means since it has replaced one silicon atom, so among 5 pentavalent atoms, 4 are shared neighborhood atoms by forming a covalent, in the form of a covalent bond, and one electron remains as a free electron. Thus it is called as a one free electrons, right? This is how the number, after adding, this is what is called as a doping. This is how one electron is a free, that means hence it is having more number of electrons, free electrons, than the more number of holes. Since the number of electrons charge is negative, this is what is called as n-type semiconductor material. So here, how the donor atom, this is a representation of donor atom. That means here the plus symbol in the center and around circle dot here. That means this is the structure, but every time the structure is not, no need to represent, because it is a tedious to draw the circuit, to draw the system or like that, the circuit or diagram. So here this is what is called a pictorial, small pictorial representation of donor atom. It is a plus and around the nucleus in the plus, and it is having free. That means one electron is ready to given to the other body, other atom. So it is called as free electron. This is what is called donor atom. And here coming to the donor ion. So donor ion is a plus with no electron, because it is already, once the donor atom becomes donor ion, one after it electron given to the others atoms. Other atom, that means this becomes a positive. That means why it is called as a positive? Because it has a capable of giving more number of electrons ready to the donors, means acceptors. So that's why it is called donate an electrons. That's why it is called a donor ion and donor atom. And these charges, the electrons are more number of electrons, means it is n-type semiconductor material. Don't confuse, the plus is nothing but a p-type, right? We are representing n-type depends on the charge carriers, not the nucleus, right?